Okay, let's be real. 2020 sucked. 2021 was better, but it still sucked. It is now 2022, the year where parks have literally no more excuses to delay any attractions. Okay, seriously, I'm just messing around. Around 1 year ago, I dropped my final part of my Florida 5-part series for the new roller coasters that were supposed to open in 2021. And out of the 5 coasters, only one of them opened. And that was the one that started construction the latest. This was Jurassic World Velocicoaster, and while this was my most anticipated ride for 2021, it still was sad to see these other coasters get pushed back even more. But that's okay, because 2022 is shaping up to be one of the best years in the amusement industry. Here in America, there are some hotspots for amusement parks. Places like Pennsylvania, Texas, and California are known for their theme parks here in the States. But the state that looks like it's getting the most this year is my home state of Florida. And today, we are going to look at every new attraction coming to the state of Florida in 2022. So let's just get straight into it. Before we get into it, there is one ride that's already open that I do want to mention, and that is the new Orlando Freefall and Orlando Slingshot at Icon Park in Orlando. They opened just a couple of days before 2022 on December 28th, 2021. So it's worth mentioning in this video, since it barely made the cut. The Slingshot is the tallest in the world, with it launching at over 100 miles an hour, 450 feet in the air, and right next to it is the world's tallest drop tower. Climb 430 feet in the air, rotating, and when you reach the top, your chairs will tilt forward around 30 degrees, and you will then free fall all the way to the bottom. I've ridden this attraction 6 times as of now, and it is one of my all-time favorite rides in Orlando, so I highly recommend you check it out. Now, let's really kick off the video heading over to Universal. Universal Orlando Resort surprisingly isn't getting much for 2022, but that's fair. They did open Jurassic World Velocicoaster last year, which arguably is the best ride in the state of Florida, and they opened the Bourne Stuntacular during the pandemic, so they can get a pass. However, there are some interesting things to note. Revenge of the Mummy over at Universal Studios is closing for an 8-month lengthy refurbishment. This premier ride's launch coaster closed on January 7th and is planned to reopen sometime in August 2022. A refurbishment like this means that some kind of change could be coming to the ride. Whether that's a queue line redo, a storyline change, a retrack, new trains, etc., we can definitely expect something new from the Revenge of the Mummy in 2022. Another thing to look at is Shrek 4D at Universal Studios. This ride closed on January 10th, and unlike Revenge of the Mummy, Shrek 4D closed permanently. What will replace this show exactly? Well, if I were to bet money on an attraction, I would say that the Secret Life of Pets Off the Leash ride at Universal Studios Hollywood would be a perfect replacement for Shrek 4D. And I heard from an employee working at the park that apparently there are permits to demolish Soundstage 4D, which is the building Shrek 4D is located in. However, now we are seeing heavy teasing by the Universal Orlando social media team, and with the themed construction walls in front of Shrek, it's looking like this attraction will be replaced with something Despicable Me related. We heard that it is going to be a Villain Con themed attraction. That was held in Orlando, Florida in the movie Minions, so it only makes sense that it would come here. However, we have no idea if it's going to be a dark ride, walkthrough, roller coaster, etc. Hopefully we will find out soon. But I would expect this to open around spring 2023. The last thing to notice at Universal Studios is Fear Factor Live. This show closed for good on March 15, 2020 and has really only been used for the Halloween Horror Nights stage shows. Since then, other than that, it sits abandoned at studios. The main rumor for this show's replacement is the Harry Potter VR experience that was supposed to be at Epic Universe. And I would not be surprised if this is what replaces Fear Factor. With Epic Universe being heavily delayed, and with Diagon Alley right next door to Fear Factor, it only makes sense that this would be its true replacement. And unless construction begins by the end of February, I would expect a spring or maybe even summer 2023 opening, which coincidentally was when Epic Universe was supposed to open. So the time would line up perfectly. Finally, we can head on over to Islands of Adventure and look at Poseidon's Fury at the Lost Continent. This show slash walkthrough attraction has been closed since March 15, 2020 as well, and starting in November of 2021, it seemed that they finally started to work on reopening this attraction. However, they are refurbishing the entire show from what it looks like, with the outdoor facades receiving a nice repaint and a new entrance sign up front that also reveals an updated name, Poseidon's Fury Escape from the Lost City. Poseidon's Fury should be reopening before March 2022, and I would expect an updated show with updated scenes throughout the entire attraction, and I know personally I'm looking forward to stepping back into Lord Darkanon's temple. Next, let's head on over to Legoland Florida in Winter Haven, Florida. Legoland is receiving the Pirate's River Quest in the Cypress Gardens section of the park in 2022. Legoland says, "Journey through the uncharted waters of the legendary Cypress Gardens and discovering the secrets protecting its canals. As this all-new story unfolds brick by brick into a family-friendly treasure hunt, adventure awaits you at Legoland on the Pirate River Quest coming in 2022. Legoland hasn't received an original ride like this in a while, so it's good to see this park getting some attention again. We can expect this attraction to be very similar to the Snake River Expedition at Cedar Point. We'll probably see a mix of real sets and maybe even some live actors throughout the attraction, as Legoland is very familiar with that. This will be a very cool ride to experience at the park. This resort, however, is also receiving the new Peppa Pig theme park. This park is opening as a second gate theme park across the parking lot from Legoland Florida. This park will feature lots of interactives like shows and playgrounds around the entire park. This park will also have rides like Mr. Bull's High Striker, which is a classic SNS frog hopper, Granddad's Dog's Pirate Island Boat Ride, which seems to be a toned-down version of the Aqua Drag Racers at Legoland Florida, Grampy Rabbit's Dinosaur Adventure, which is a near clone of the Royal Joust attraction, also at Legoland Florida, Peppa Pig's Balloon Ride, which is an aerial balloon carousel as seen in many other parks, and finally, Daddy Pig's Roller Coaster, an extended Zamperla family coaster that will also include a small drive tire launch. Peppa Pig Theme Park will be a great addition to the Florida Parks lineup. This park opens on February 24th, 2022 to the public, and I'm very excited to see what this park has to offer. Continuing our trek to the west coast of Florida, we now arrive at Busch Gardens Tampa and Adventure Island. Adventure Island Water Park is receiving a couple of attractions for the 2022 season. The first one of Adventure Island slides named Wahoo Run, which was a large raft slide, is getting repainted and retracked with some modern slide pieces and being renamed Wahoo Remix. Adventure Island says, "Wahoo Remix will be Adventure Island's first water slide to feature synchronized light and sound elements, delivering an all-new high-energy family raft ride experience with ultimate party vibes. Enclosed tunnels that were once dark will now glow and groove as riders zoom through over 600 feet of fun." The next slide Adventure Island is receiving is a ground-up water slide that is replacing the old Runaway Rapids body slides. This is the Rapids Racer Water Coaster. Adventure Island says, "Riders grab a two-person raft before racing through nearly 600 feet of slide, complete with low walls to encounter your opponents throughout the side-by-side experience. The thrill of the chase is amplified as guests swirl through the world's first dueling saucers in this exhilarating journey full of high-speed tunnels, turns, and more." This slide will be pretty similar to the Riptide Race at Aquatica, but it's good to see Adventure Island receiving this kind of slide. Now, going across the street to Busch Gardens Tampa, they are receiving quite possibly the most anticipated roller coaster edition in 2022 worldwide. This is obviously Iron Gwazi, the new RMC Hyper Hybrid that replaced the original dueling GCI wooden coaster, Gwazi. This will be Florida's first true hybrid coaster, and this coaster was originally supposed to open in spring of 2020, however was delayed due to the lovely COVID-19 pandemic, and is finally supposed to open in March of 2022. No opening date has been given for it yet, but I would not be surprised if one is announced soon. On this ride, you can expect lots of airtime, forces, snappy inversions, and overall an out-of-control experience from start to finish. This ride will feature the steepest drop on a hybrid coaster with a 91-degree angle, and this coaster is already shaping up to be one of, if not the best roller coaster, in the entire world. And we enthusiasts can't wait to finally experience this beast of a coaster. Moving on back over to Orlando, we now arrive at SeaWorld Orlando and Aquatica. In 2022, Aquatica is receiving Reef Plunge, an updated version of one of their older slides, Dolphin Plunge. This slide is a classic enclosed body slide, but at the very end, you go through a clear tube through a dolphin tank and get up close with the dolphins. It's a very cool slide, and now they're making it even better. Aquatica says, "Splash, twist, and turn through over 330 feet of eye-catching, translucent cutouts and rings. Zoom past a dynamic new underwater habitat that's home to a vibrant array of marine life, including commercent dolphins, leopard sharks, sardines, and other cold water fish. This effect will be very similar to the one on Solar Vortex at Adventure Island with its aqualucent lighting. That's it for Aquatica in 2022. So now heading on over to SeaWorld Orlando, they are finally opening their Premier Rides quadruple launch coaster, Icebreaker. Similar to Iron Gwazi, this ride was supposed to open in spring of 2020, but it was delayed to the COVID-19 pandemic. The coaster is set to open on February 18, 2022, with passholder previews beginning on January 30, 2022. This multi-launch coaster will be a short but action-packed coaster with lots of airtime, forwards and backwards launches, and a beyond vertical spike. So you can expect this ride to be one of the best in the park. Finally, let's head over to our last destination, Walt Disney World Resort. At Animal Kingdom, Primeval World, their spinning wild mouse clones have been demolished, and its replacement won't open in 2022. And Hollywood Studios isn't receiving anything new for this year at all. Magic Kingdom is building Tron Light Cycle Run, a Vekoma custom booster bike themed to the Tron franchise. There is an exact clone of this ride over at Shanghai Disneyland called Tron Light Cycle Power Run if you want to get an idea about this ride. This launch coaster will include a 65 mile per hour launch, a small outdoor section, and an indoor theme section that will include lots of twists and turns. This ride was originally supposed to open in summer 2021, however, it was delayed thanks to our good old jolly friend, the COVID-19 pandemic. Even this ride should open in 2022, however, it looks like this attraction will open in the spring or summer of 2023. Our final attraction we'll be taking a look at is over at Epcot. This is the Guardians of the Galaxy Cosmic Rewind roller coaster. This will be Epcot's first ever roller coaster in its 40 years of operation, and it replaced the old Universe of Energy dark ride. This ride has now been in construction for nearly 5 whole years. This highly themed roller coaster will contain a 60 plus mile per hour backwards launch, and judging by this picture, this coaster will most likely be a multi-launch coaster. The track length is over 5,000 feet, so we can expect a long ride experience. This coaster will be a spinning coaster, but it will be controlled and will contain the same experience every time you ride it. It will be made by Vekoma, and Disney is calling this ride a storytelling coaster, where the trains will always spin towards the story. This coaster will be thrilling, but family-oriented at the same time, and it is finally set to open in the summer of 2022. And there we have it, every ride coming to the state of Florida in 2022. Hopefully, none of them get delayed again due to our lovely friend, the COVID-19 pandemic. If you're new to this channel and you enjoyed this video and want to see more like it, make sure you subscribe. And if you want to hear more about these new additions, then check out my podcast, On the Hunt, in the description down below. Finally, if you ever need non-copyrighted off-ride footage or POVs, check out my second channel, TPH Productions. Link is in the description down below. As always, this is Hunter from Theme Park Hunting. I'll see you guys later, and follow the thrill.